problems by practicing using the distributive property to solve multiplication problems. Remember what distributive property is, the one we just focused on?
Hi everyone, my name is James Brown. I am the principal of the Stockton School in District 14, PS 297. So, my own personal experience, I hear many people talk about how they are a product of the public school system. Myself, honestly, I'm not. I went to parochial school, Lutheran, from first to eighth grade. I was named the St. Stephen Parochial School. I also attended the Nazareth Regional Catholic High School. Now, in being a student at both these schools, I was exposed to everything from higher vocabulary, which happens to be our instructional focus this year in teaching our students how to do tier two words and say it and use it and mean it, to Bach, Beethoven, Mozart. And as I grew, as I became a principal, I understood that not everyone could afford what my parents could afford to send their child and my two sisters to private schools. Yet and still, the love of education, education itself, should not be beyond anyone. So one of the things I fight for as a principal of the Stockton School, or 297 as it is known, is to ensure that we give our children everything that I had as a child. Like I said, exposure to music, exposure to the arts, exposure to solid curriculum, making sure that the teachers do their jobs and holding everyone accountable, not only myself, but them, our parents, and ultimately our students themselves. 60% of our students are of Latino descent. So one of the things we try to do, the very first event that we celebrate, is Hispanic Heritage. This gives us a time to celebrate those heroes in the Latino community, our Latino staff members, and other heroes that are throughout the city, the country, the nation, and give our students overall a chance to know who those people are, those who have passed away, and those who continue to remain to fight the strong fight on behalf of the Latino community. We celebrate that with poems, shows, food. Oh, the food. That's one thing you will never run short of at PS 297. What we want from everyone is their best. Now, I understand that not everyone's best is of equal value. But if you are bringing your effort to 297, we will work with whatever you have. Whether it is our L students, our special education students, our general education students, and our students who have more accelerated abilities, we are able to service them all. I say that because I believe in the staff that we have here and how diligently I work with them, how much I see them work because of the support staff that we have in place. Everyone from my assistant principal to my OT teachers to my community director. When we come here, we come and we leave it on the ground as if it was a football game. When I was younger, I used to wrestle and the coach said to leave it on the mat. That's how I feel we should do when we are educating our children. We leave it on the mat. We give our all from September to June and then again for my assistant principal and I, July and August. This job, it never stops. And we're here to implore you to make sure that you come along. Check us out, see what we're about. As we continue to grow in this practice and ensure that every child not only learns, but that they enjoy learning. So that they are able to, as I always say, become a citizen of our global society. Because what I'm doing, it goes so far beyond Bedford-Stuyvesant. What I want to do is have our students reach different parts of the world. I want them to believe that they can succeed just as much as I was able to do on that private education, that they could do the same thing on the public education with adults and colleagues of students and peers that believe in them. We love celebrating our Harvest Feast. Our Harvest Feast is done the Tuesday right before Thanksgiving every year. We do this in honor of a former school aide, Sylvia Robinson, who means a great deal to this community.